Bharati Vidya Bhavan, as you're all aware, was started in 1948 by Dr. K.M. Munshi. The initial objective with which Dr. Munshiji started Bharati Vidya Bhavan was to propagate Indian culture and promote the concepts of Indian culture which at that point of time were becoming weak. About 6 years ago, an opportunity came in the way of the Bangalore Kendra of the Bharati Vidya Bhavan. The Brihat Bangalore Mahanagara Palike had a school which was virtually defunct in the midst of the slum areas of Srirampuram. Realizing that the school was not serving the purpose for which it was established, a discussion ensued between Bharati Vidya Bhavan Bangalore Kendra and the BBMP. A memorandum of understanding was signed between these two institutions. In fact, this is one of its kind in the country.
Today, providing quality education, particularly for poor children in India, is a real challenge. Even the government has not been able to come out with a clear-cut policy or the program, particularly for the children who have no educational background in the family. In this direction, all the people connected with education has to work hard how to provide good education, quality education for the poor people who cannot afford a very quality education which is now available only for the upper middle class people. This aspect has been addressed to some extent by Bharati Vidya Bhavan and BBMP in collaboration with a small school in Srirampuram.
As per this memorandum of understanding, Bharati Vidya Bhavan took over the responsibility of running and administering the school at Srirampuram. The BBMP promised to construct a good building for the purpose of running the school and also provide the land for the same. And true to their promise, I must go on record that the BBMP did fulfill their promise. Today, we have a ground plus two floors building with a compound, and there is a playground for the children. With all this, Bharati Vidya Bhavan took over the running and administering the school. The school today has over 450 children in the standards from nursery to the sixth. The children are predominantly from the neighboring areas in Srirampuram, which is mostly in the slums of Srirampuram. The children who attend the school here are virtually first-time school-going children.
The best class of education is provided in the school to the children, and we focus on the overall development of the child by not only focusing on academics but also to bring out a creative instinct and compatibility with today's education system. The children here are so willing to learn and pursue knowledge with great enthusiasm. In the year 2019 and 20, our first children will take 10th standard exam.
This is the model school which can be replicated by many other agencies in India and abroad, because in this there is no commitment with regard to money.
It is necessary to note that Srirampuram for some reason had acquired the reputation of being a very notorious locality. Rowdyism was the order of the day. In fact, this was a law and order problem locality in the city of Bangalore.
Essentially, the children come from really deprived sections And in fact, we have had many examples of children coming from pretty disturbed homes where the parents have either committed suicide or there are drunken fathers and there's a lot of domestic violence. So the children come to the school, and in fact the school environment is a very nurturing and nourishing environment for these children. But when they do go back, they go back to the homes. Plan of Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan is to even include the parents in this process of education, so that when the children go back to their homes, they don't find the home environment very different from that of the school environment.
And we are trying to give to the parents vocational training, Kalabharti classes, and we wanted to change through children the houses of the society of Sri Ramakrishna.
This school believes providing not only an academic education for the children, but also to how to give them a total, personality development in their life. In this direction, we have introduced yoga, we have introduced music, we introduced the dance, we have introduced many other sports activities which can give them the holistic education, not only just for the sake of the passing out from the school, but to make them a great human being.
ನಮಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಆದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಮಗುಗೆ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಬೇರೆ ಸ್ಕೂಲಲ್ಲಿ ಇತ್ತು ಮಗು, ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಎತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಂದು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಶಿಫ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಶಿಫ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಗು ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಾತಾಡೋದು, ಒಂದು ಎಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ಐಡಿಯಾ ಗೀಡಿಯಾ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಒಂಥರ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಬಂದಮೇಲೆ ನಮಗೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅನುಕೂಲ ಆಯಿತು. ಆ ಮಗು ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಈಗ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಓದ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾಳೆ. ಎಲ್ಲ ಇದು ಪ್ರಾಜೆಕ್ಟು ಎಲ್ಲ ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕಂದ್ರೂ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅವಳೇ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು, ಟ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಗೀಷನ್ಗಂದ ಹಾಕಿಲ್ಲ ಮಗುಗೆ. ಎಲ್ಲ ಈ ಸ್ಕೂಲಲ್ಲಿ ಆದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನಮಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅನುಕೂಲ ಆಯಿತು. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕಿ ನಮಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಮು ಇಲ್ಲ. ನಮಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇರೋರು ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಾಲು ಮಿಸ್ ಆಗಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನಮಗೆ ತುಂಬ ಕೋಪ್ರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಏನೂ ಒಂದು ಡಿಸ್ಟರ್ಬೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ನಮಗೆ, ಮಗುಗೆ ಮಗುಗಾಗಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ನಮಗೂ ಆಗಲಿ. ಎಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಅವರೇ ಎಲ್ಲ ನೋಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಎಲ್ಲ ಏನಿದೆ ಒಂದು ತೊಂದರೆ ಇದ್ರೂ ಹೇಳ್ಕಳಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಏನೋ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಇದ್ದರೆ ಇದು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಅವರೇ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾರೆ. ನಮ್ಗೆ ಅಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಒಂದು ಅನುಕೂಲ ಇದೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ.
ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಮೈ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಸೇ ದಟ್ ಅಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ದೇ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಗುಡ್ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಗುಡ್ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ಗುಡ್ ನೈಸ್ ಇನ್ಫ್ರಾಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಗುಡ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗುಡ್ ಟಾಯ್ಲೆಟ್ ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟೀಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈವನ್ ಎಂಬಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡೆಡಿಕೇಟೆಡ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ಯು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಸ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಮಗ್ ಅಪ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ದೇ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ದಟ್ ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡೆಡಿಕೇಟೆಡ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಶೋಸ್ ಆನ್ ದ the way students interact, that is good.
Our classes are very heterogeneous. The children are very varying abilities. The differences among students is very high. So we have learned to suit our teaching methodology to accommodate the needs of all the children. The classroom teaching is molded such that time is given to all children according to their individual capacity and learning orientation. The same applies to evaluation process also.
We now have the police authorities themselves and coming and telling us that the locality has now changed from being a rowdy locality to a very law abiding locality. This is what the school has done to the entire locality. The children who have come to this school have become game changers. They have in fact educated their parents on good behavior. We have children who come here from 8 o'clock in the morning, who stay with us till 3:30, attend to several activities, both curricular and extracurricular. To run the school, we have a very able set of staff who are both teaching and non-teaching. And the staff of the school have become emotionally involved with the running of the institution. It is not work to rule, they work from their heart. And this school has received encouragement from several quarters.
This is a question of commitment towards the quality of education, and now with the help of many agencies like Rotary International, Indranagar, and we have Suprajit Foundation, and we have with the Infosys Foundation, and many other agencies are coming forward to help the school in such a way so that the poor children get the quality education in a befitting manner.
Bharati Vidya Bhavan BBMP school is a perfect example of how public-private partnership can work excellently. It has not only changed the lives of much-needed youngsters, kids who cannot afford an education of the quality that is provided by this school, but also it is equally important to know that the parents and the surrounding has been positively impacted by the school in this area. We at Suprajit Foundation are exceedingly proud to be associated with this project and to make a difference to the society and to give an education for the much needy children of this area through Bharati Vidya Bhavan and BBMP school is something that we are truly privileged to be associated with.
We have several other donors who have come voluntarily to support the school. We are grateful to each and every one of them. The school has a minimum fee which it charges the children. It barely covers the expenses. In fact, 50% of the students who are admitted to the school are from the BBMP side. The remaining 50% are appointed or admitted by the Bhavan. The school also admits children through the RTE quota. We have support from the ISKCON, the Akshaya Patra Foundation, who provide to the children the midday meal scheme. All these clearly indicate that for good causes, there is no dearth for money. We are confident that the school will grow from strength to strength, and each year we are adding 80 students to the school. And the school is now looking at getting affiliation with the CBSE, and we are hopeful that in the years to come, the school will become a very attractive place for children from the lower strata of society to expose themselves to the opportunity of getting educated. It is also necessary for me to mention that the school provides a regular health checkup for the children. We have had dental camps, we have had eye camps, we have had general health camps for the children, and all this has contributed to the general welfare of the children. We have, as part of augmenting the resources and support to the school, we have a program which we have labeled as Sponsor a Child program, and the contributions that are made to the school are contributions to the Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan, which has been declared as an institution of national eminence. And contribution to the Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan is exempt from income tax 100%. We are hopeful that this school, which, if I may say so, is the flagship activity of the Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan Bangalore Kendra, will go from strength to strength and serve the larger interests of the community, more particularly those who have been deprived till now of an opportunity of good education.